Now, I very respectfully invite the Most Venerable Heenepola Gunaratna Thero to deliver a brief sermon. Let me once again welcome you, Reverend Sir, to the commemoration day of Vesak, and we are truly honored by your presence with us today.
Venerable Mahasangha, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, we are celebrating the Vesak. On this occasion, I have been asked to speak on bringing peace to the world through the Buddhist philosophy. The Buddha's message is, in essence, peace. Buddha recognized that we all have one common problem. He diagnosed our problem. That is one universal suffering. Then he diagnosed that this has a cause. Then he diagnosed that this can be eliminated. In order to eliminate, he gave three-step treatment. This first one is suffering caused by our greed. That is the root of our suffering. In order to get rid of our greed, instead of pointing our finger at somebody else, we must look at ourselves, see how much greed, how much craving we have to grab, collect, accumulate, even at the expense of millions of people suffering in the world. Those who can acquire wealth, possess wealth, and they greedily hold on to their wealth. They have no desire for sharing their wealth. And they, instead of bringing peace, they increase our suffering. Second is our hatred. Every bomb, every gun that we produced is not going to bring peace. We instead create more problems, more suffering. This United Nations is originally created to bring peace. We should ask ourselves honestly and sincerely, looking at our own mind, focusing our own mind, are we fulfilling the purpose of this wonderful organization as our forefathers created it? This is the second problem, that is our hatred. And third is, we have to think of how we ourselves create peace within ourselves. We cannot preach others to be peaceful if we do not have it within ourselves. We cannot ask others to be generous if we do not practice it. If we are very cruel. We cannot ask others to practice compassion. So each and every one of us must very honestly, sincerely, in order to respect the Buddha on this very auspicious day, we must commit ourselves to practice what he said us to practice. Only then can we bring world peace. In our earlier talks, we heard our speakers mentioning that we must practice metta, loving friendliness. Friends, venerable monks, and our excellencies, we all must work together in friendliness to bring peace and happiness by practicing the Buddha's teaching. In order to bring joy, happiness, comfort, and peace to the world, we must develop it within ourselves. So, I like to mention that Buddha's deepest message is not out in the books, not in libraries, not in universities. His message is in our heart and mind. We, each and every one of us, must commit ourselves to practice what he has asked us to practice for 45 years, 2,600 years ago. That message is as valid, as meaningful, as beneficial today as it was then in the time of the Buddha. So I like to conclude my very little brief talk. This is a very big subject. It might take many hours to explain, but within this such a short time, I want to conclude this message by saying the message of metta, loving friendliness. I want to say it in English so that we all can understand it. May all beings be happy and secure. May all beings have happy minds, whatever living beings there may be, without exception, weak or strong, long, large, medium, short, subtle or gross, visible or invisible, living near or far, born or coming to birth, may all beings have happy minds. Let no one deceive another, nor despise anyone anywhere. Neither from anger nor ill will should anyone wish harm to others. Just like a mother would protect her only child, even at the risk of her own life, one should practice loving friendliness towards all living beings, whether standing, sitting, lying down, or whenever awake. One should develop this mindfulness. This is called divinely dwelling here, not falling into erroneous views, virtuous and endowed with vision. One should develop this mindfulness, and may all of us wish that let all of us cultivate this thought in our heart and mind, and then we can develop peace within ourselves. With that peaceful state of mind, we can work together, whether standing, sitting, walking, lying down. These are not something to be practiced by sitting in one place. This to be expressed in our words and deeds. Only then can we bring peace and happiness to the world. I wish you all very happy Buddha's birthday. Thank you.